All right. Hello, everyone. This is Vibhor Kumar. I'm from EnterpriseDB. I'm not sure how many of you are aware about the EnterpriseDB. EnterpriseDB is a company who actually took the open source database called PostgreSQL, and we created a enterprise level feature around it, you know, so that we make it easy to use and make it more secure and performant. So in this presentation, I'm going to talk about the EDB Postgres Ark. It's another product which actually helps customer to create their own database as a service platform, right? Using OpenStack, or if you're using any other cloud, you will be able to create your own database as a service platform. So EDB Ark, of course, I mean, this is an OpenStack conference, of course, I'll be covering mostly on the OpenStack part. EDB Ark actually helps you to deploy Postgres very easily, and you can manage the Postgres databases very easily with the OpenStack. It's certified on the Mitaka, Newton, or Okta, and it's also certified in the AWS clouds. It gives you a value in the sense of that you can deploy the Postgres, you can pick up the cloud, whichever you want to use, and you can easily deploy the Postgres there. And it's a highly available cluster which you can deploy using the EDB Ark. From the business initiative perspective, developers doesn't have to worry about that they have to create a highly available cluster in the cloud. They can just only click on one button, the Postgres will be available in your OpenStack environment, and they can actually focus on developing the applications. And of course, it lowers the cost too. From the cloud management perspective, if you look at that, this particular small diagram, right? You can create your own development instances where you can have one EDB Postgres cluster running and you can use it, or you can have the production cluster ready in the OpenStack world where you can have the master standby, you can use for the disaster recovery altogether. It actually includes the capability from the Amazon or OpenStack altogether, gives the extra capability on top of those, like creating, cloning a database, or if you want to scale your database altogether in that platform. You can also create a kind of an encrypted, transparent data encryption methodology, which was included in the OpenStack with the EDB Postgres. Without EDB Ark, most of the DevOps team and most of the DevOps DBAs, they focus on actually developing multiple scripts or maybe looking or exploring the all possible APIs given by the particular platform, right? And they actually work a lot, you know, create a database as a service platform using a infrastructure as a service platform. Now, EDB, I've seen in the real time that most of the enterprises, they actually spend around 6 months, sometimes 1 year, to develop the whole components together so that they can make a database as a service platform using the infrastructure altogether. With EDB Ark, it's very simple, straightforward, right? You can see you will get one small console where you can choose your cluster name, you can choose the version which you want to deploy in the OpenStack, right? And plus you can also choose the network in which you want to create the whole cluster altogether. It's very straightforward, simple, and easy. EDB Ark console, if you look at it here, it gives you a lot of capabilities, right? You can see there is a way you can create one complete cluster. You can scale up and scale down based on the workload which you have. And plus, if you want, you can take a backup too. And if there's any new patches got released by the EDB, you can deploy it easily by one click. With this, you can also create a kind of a hybrid cloud platform. So when I'm saying hybrid cloud platform, you can use OpenStack, and suppose if you want to use Amazon AWS, or if you want to use a container, anything you would like, you would be able to control everything, and you can easily deploy the Postgres on all those platforms. So you can see here, you can use private and public cloud both together with the EDB Ark. EDB Ark is a little different from the normal way of actually creating a database as a service platform, because in EDB Ark, what we have thought through about it, because we had seen the issues which customers face, right, when they want to develop this kind of a platform. So we had seen those issues, and that's why we actually focused on developing a product which can out of the box gives the capability to treat your OpenStack cloud or public or private cloud and create a kind of a database as a service platform. It provides you RESTful API so that you can easily integrate if you're using your own interfaces, right? So let's, since it's a demo kind of a thing, so I'll move to the demo part. In demo part, what I'm going to cover the EDB Ark, how you can see the operational management capabilities, and DB and developer end users, how they can use EDB Ark very easily. All right, so you can see here, this is the console called EDB Ark console, where you can actually enter your username, password. If you're the OPS manager, you will get extra capability on the EDB Ark side. So in the console itself, you can see the name of the console. I mean, you can define your own name too, right? And since you're the OPS manager, then you have a capability of the admin, DBA user, and cluster creation too. Here you can see there is one cluster created. It's a single node cluster. This is only for the development purpose, right? You can see that. And there is another cluster, which is a production cluster, where you have a master and the standby. So there is a two node cluster, which you can see here. Now, if you want to see all these clusters on your normal Horizon OpenStack interface, you will be able to see that too. So let's look at this OpenStack console. There you can see, this is a normal dashboard, and here you can see number of CPUs and the memory which is getting utilized. Plus you can see the uptime, and there you can see the two apps which we have created using the EDB Ark, my web app and other pieces too. Let's go back to the, of course, in the EDB Ark console. And EDB Ark console, you can see, you will be able to create your own templates too. So here, suppose if you want to make your own template using the whatever the out-of-the-box templates available, you will be able to do that. So as an OPS manager, if you want to include your own functionality or own capability, you can do that easily. So you can pick up the specific database engine. You can click on the Edit button. Excuse me. And in that, you can see there's an ID information, DB type, name. If you want to change the name, you can change the name too. Plus, if you want to include your extra components through your YAML repository, you can do that. And with this, you can also define a kind of a complete capability or required packages in the template itself, using the required DB packages. Now, after modifying the existing template, if you want to make your own or build your own template, you can do that. You can add the capability like PostGIS, PL, Python, all together into the one database instance, right? You can name that particular ID. You can choose the database type, whether you want to deploy advanced server or the PostgreSQL, the version of it. You can name the engine too, sorry. And then after that, you can choose the server type. So server type will be your kind of operating system template or the image which you want to use from the OpenStack. Now, with these information, if you want to add your own extra packages, like if you want to deploy Puppet or Ansible Chef modules, you can do that very easily by actually including those components in the YAML repo. And then after that, you can also mention the optional packages too. That's it. Your image is ready. And using this image, you will be able to create your own cluster too. So let's go back to the cluster console. In the cluster console, there is an extra capability called looking at the updates. Thank you. Thank you so much. So in this update package, you can see there is a alert which is coming up showing that there is an update available for this particular template. you can click on the update button and it will automatically update or apply the patches on your instances. You can monitor those pieces easily through the event log. So you can see there is an event tab through which you can see what is going on in your cluster. You can also monitor that how your server is performing. You can see the CPU utilization, disk space utilization, and the load on the server. You can get more information about your cluster, like in which region it's installed. So you can see all information which you need is already available in the EDB Ark. With that, you can also change the size of your instance too. So suppose if you want to increase the number of CPU and memory, you can choose the size too. So here you can see that when you did the scale up, in the scale up it actually added extra CPUs and memory based on the images, and it's also scaling up the master and the replica both. So you can see, and you can also verify that information together on the EDB Ark console. With all these information, we also provide to the REST API. Using the REST API, you will be able to integrate the EDB Ark with your own infrastructure very easily. So in the REST API, there is called GET API. In the GET API, if you want to know more about your cluster or the instances which are running on the OpenStack, you can do that easily. You can see that it's very simple and straightforward. Here you can see, it's giving you the information of your instances, all information, like whether it's auto-scale true or not, availability zone information, cluster name information, number of CPU, memory utilization, and the cluster key, which is actually created using that instances. So you can see, in this whole demo, what you have seen is that how easy it is to create a highly available EDB Postgres instance in the OpenStack. Right, you have seen the cluster properties. The cluster properties are already available on the console itself. You can scale up, scale down your cluster very easily. When I'm saying scale up, it means if you want to add more CPU, more memory in your cluster, you can do that easily. Right, and if you want to apply any special patches, if the patch got released. So other capability which you can see here, so far we have seen the ability of Ops Manager or Ops DBA that it can create their own images too. Here what we are going to show you that how the normal DBA, normal user, will be able to create the cluster, the image which was created by the Ops Manager. So you can see you can click on the create cluster, you can choose the cluster name, you can choose the engine name, the engine or the template which was defined by the OPS Manager. You can choose the server type, whether it's a small or medium, and the number of nodes which you want to create. So with one click, you can see you will be able to create your own cluster. And if you want to see exactly what's going on during the creation of the cluster, you can look at the event log. Now, if you want to know more detail, you can see the detail information is already available on the left-hand side of a tab. And if you want to download the SSH, suppose if you want to do SSH to the server, you can do that easily. You can download the key, and after downloading a key, you can use SSH command, to directly connect to your instance. So here you can see that you can easily do the SSH. After doing the SSH, if you want to connect to a database, you can use a PSQL client, the client which comes with the Postgres. This way you can see you are connecting to a database called Postgres. Right? Here you are connected. And if you want to list out all the databases which is inside the one cluster, you can use list command in the PSQL client. And there you can see. Next part is that if you want to switch your particular console from the OpenStack to the, let's say if you're using the AWS public cloud, right? You can do that very easily. So as I told you, that EDB Ark out of the box provides the power, the flexibility that you can actually host your database instances in any of the cloud, whether it's a public cloud like Amazon RDS, or if you want to use your private cloud using the OpenStack. So here you can see there's a four node cluster which is created in the AWS US East region. Now if you want to clone that particular cluster, you can do that too. With one single click, you will get this kind of a pop-up window where you can choose the network where you want to deploy the, or clone that particular instance, and that's all. And you can see then how it's going to clone. So what it does behind the scene is that it actually takes the snapshot backup of your whole instance altogether and builds a new instance, which is more like a cloning process. So you can see it's very easy and simple, right? It gives you power that you can make your own database as a service platform, right? So EDB, that's why keeping all those in mind, we decided to develop an EDB Ark, a product, right, which can run out of the box on any platform, whether it's an OpenStack, whether it's a AWS Cloud, or whether it's a Microsoft Azure, anyone. Now, after using the particular instance, if the developer wants to terminate an instance, they can do that very easily with one click, right? And you can see now we are terminating the particular instance when we use it correctly. So this covers the complete demo on the EDB Ark. Right here, what we are, you have seen how you can easily create a new instance, deploy a Postgres, highly available Postgres cluster in the cloud. You will be able to do the SSH to the particular instance. You can actually use PSQL client library or any other client library to connect to your database. If you want to switch between two different consoles, you can do that easily with the EDB Ark. And if you want to clone a database instance which is already running in the OpenStack, or whether it's running in the AWS cloud, you can easily do that with one click. So this is all about the demo, which you can see here, right? So if you have any question, you can ask me. And we also have one booth from the EnterpriseDB. You can stop by, you can discuss more about the we can discuss more about the EDB Postgres, the PostgreSQL database. Thank you.